Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
No, okay, go ahead. Taking up from there, where he has left, you were called the demolition man of Delhi. After you have left, what has changed in Delhi? Are there no more illegal structures or are there no more bureaucrats who have the spine like you had?
Well, DK, I wouldn't like to really denounce a service or anybody. I don't do that. The point is that when I was commissioner DDA, not one inch of land in Delhi was encroached. And it's possible. Not one illegal brick was laid. Now, is that possible? Do you have the power to do it? A lot of IAS officers would say, no, there's political interference. I can't do it. It's all complete fake stories. The IAS, all your services have incredible power. You can do whatever you want. I've demolished cabinet ministers, at least half a dozen of them when I was commissioner DDA. You have the power to do it, and you will continue to do it. And all this is fake stories saying that the political system doesn't allow me, the bureaucratic system doesn't allow me. All this is all bullshit. You can do whatever you want. Hmm.
So the efforts that Supreme Court made after that, Supreme Court and Delhi High Court, did they work or not work? Because there were many phases of demolitions, ceilings in Delhi.
Actually, Shagar, people can keep issuing orders. And of course, those should really be respected. And but even I was empowered by the Supreme Court. Hmm. I went to Justice Kuldeep Singh,
right,
the Open Court, and said, I can't be issuing notices in all these cases when there is an encroachment, because then he will go and get a stay from the sub-court. And then it will drag on for 25, 30 years, 50 years. So the Supreme Court gave me an enabling order which said that I don't need to issue notices for my demolition. So the court has been hugely helpful. But a lot of people take cover under the courts, Supreme Court and High Court, saying, let the order come from the Supreme Court, then we will do it. Why are we waiting? Why are we surrendering our authority, our responsibility to the Supreme Court? I mean, I'm paid a salary by the government to do all these things. Why are we waiting to clean up Delhi or any city? Why should we wait for a court order? You have such incredible powers, and you can do it. And of course, a lot of people don't want to take the responsibility, I guess, because it's dangerous, and it's a lot of work, yeah.
So are you saying bureaucrats are scared today?
Well, if you can get away not doing it, why should you do it? It's very comfortable sitting in the comfort of your air-conditioned room and issuing beautiful orders on your files. But the actual fact is, all these beautiful orders in your file remain on your file and nothing happens on the ground. I mean, if you want to really do things out there, if you're going to say, okay, now demolish this guy, like the first building I demolished belonged to the biggest mafia leader of Delhi. And the size of the building was 200,000 square feet. If I write on my file now, go and demolish him, you think my employees will have the guts to go and do it? So I was there right in front.
This was the Carolbagh guy? Who was this?
No, this was in Model Town.
Model Town.
When I say the biggest mafia leader of Delhi, I assume you possibly know who he is.
Why didn't you mention
1984 riots.
Right.
So you know whom I'm hinting at. So you got to be there leading and telling people now, yeah, I'm there, just do it.
I mean, the tricky one, I could name any of the four people. And any of the four would then be called biggest mafia leader of Delhi. So
okay.
You tell me who
clue,
it was.
Clue number one, he's not alive anymore.
I see.
Okay.
So this is HKL Bhagat.
Obviously.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So one has really got to lead out there on the ground and say, now it's possible to do it. Now, did I do all these things alone? Not at all. Like, we demolished 14,310 illegal mansions in Delhi. Did I do it? No. We did it together. I had 36,000 employees. And finally, after possibly a year or something, me being on the ground, if I just told my employees, go and demolish anything under the sun, they would do it. Even if you told them, go and demolish the Rashtrapati Bhavan, they would still do it. So it's a question of making sure
don't give people ideas.
And Shagar, even this demolishing this 200,000 square feet building of HKL Bhagat, a lot of people think that it's, oh my God, this is a miracle. Actually, there's nothing like that. You just got to be clever. You got to find out which are the pillars, the load-bearing pillars. You knock out a few of them, and the building collapses, and it's such a beautiful feeling, you know, when you see this happen.